lovely people, you're welcome to my YouTube channel. It's so good to have you back here again. Today, I'm going to talk about how to heal and recover from a broken heart. Yes, I've received this question a million times, and I think it's time I did address it. And whatever I'll be sharing here is going to be based on my own experience on how I healed from my past breakups. And I want you to know that it is not automatic. No, you need to work on it. You need to work on yourself to be able to heal from your heartbreak. When I was recording this video, I received this message, and I believe this is a confirmation from God that there are many people who are going to be healed and who are going to recover from situations like this. God is going to heal you. And I believe this video is going to be a great help to you if you apply the methods I'm about. Reality that it's over. Yes, I did. You have to accept that it's all over. No more false hopes. Yes, I tried to save the relationship, but when I realized that all hope is lost, when I lost trust, I realized that no, I can't anymore. Because when the trust is lost, you're always going to be doubting the person. You're always going to be feeling insecure. The love wouldn't even be there like it used to. So I just felt like, okay, I accepted this, it's over, and I need to move on. So please accept the fact that it's over. Stop trying to push in and force it to work. It doesn't work that way. You're just going to keep on hurting yourself. Secondly, I acknowledged my pain and I cried. I cried so hard. They say that crying makes you weak. No, sometimes crying makes you feel better when you pour it all out. And acknowledge your pain. Yes, accept the fact that you are hurt. Some people after breakup, they feel, oh, I'm strong, I can do without him. All my single ladies acting all, I'm okay. But deep down, you're so hurt, you are killing yourself. You're all smiles and happy in front of your friends, but when you're alone on your bed, that is when you start crying. No, who are you deceiving? Acknowledge the pain. Accept that yes, you are hurt, and it's okay to cry. Cry it all out. Cry it all out, and you feel better. But for me, crying is one of my best remedies. When I cry, I feel okay. So it's okay to acknowledge your pain and cry a bit. I forgive. Yes, as much as it was so painful and I was in so much, I don't know how to explain it. I had to forgive, because one of the remedies of healing is forgiveness. You need to forgive the person, and you also need to forgive yourself. You can't blame it all on the person. Yes, it might be the person's fault, but you also have to accept part of the blame, because you are not perfect. You are not perfect. I'm sure you also made some mistakes. So forgive him, forgive her, and also forgive yourself. The fourth one, I prayed and committed myself to the Lord. Every time I remember the pain, I always tell God, God, please help me heal. These memories keep coming back. Please help me heal. And anytime I finish praying this prayer, I feel safe. Yes, memories will still come. There are things that will remind you of the person. Sometimes you sit there and you start thinking about the person. It's okay, but whenever it happens, say this little prayer. Lord, help me heal. You feel that a prayer is nothing, but it really works in so many ways. So many ways. You have no idea. The fifth one, please. This is very important, but it's very difficult. Please, for the meantime, delete the person's number. Delete all the pictures you have on your phone or your laptop or wherever with the person. This is all part of the healing process, because you still have their numbers. You see them on your WhatsApp status. You see them, their pictures everywhere. All being happy with either themselves or with someone else. you can't heal. You feel so hurt. You even start getting angry. You know, like, hey, this person is all happy without me. All of a sudden, the person has moved on and I'm still here. So, for the meantime, just delete the person's number. Everything that reminds you of the person, erase it. That will help you heal. That is all part of the healing process for a while. Like I said, the memories will still be coming up. So what I also did is I saturated my mind with God's word. I get this question a lot of times. How do you read God's word? How do you sync it with your prayers? There's Google. You just search what interests you. How to heal from a broken heart with scriptures. How to gain more faith in the Lord with scriptures. How to heal with scriptures. You see a lot of it on Google when you research. And whilst you are praying, you pray according to the word of God, or you keep saying and memorizing and speaking God's word. It really helps. It really helps. Keep yourself busy. Don't be all bored and idle and memories will still keep flashing up. Keep yourself busy. You can watch movies. You can listen to gospel music. Yes, very important. Erase yourself or erase your mind for delete all love songs. Don't watch movies that have love scenes. I mean, remove things that would remind you of the person. It's very important. It's all part of your healing process. And replace them with the word of God. Yes, I might act all spiritual and cliche and all that, but it really helps. With the word of God, listen to gospel music. Get yourself busy. Get yourself busy. Don't feel all miserable and alone and all heartbroken and you can't do anything without the person. You can. If you help yourself. And also, I didn't enter into a new relationship immediately I broke up. That is what most people do, and that is a very big mistake. Most people feel like, oh, if I enter into a new relationship, that will help me forget about my past and be happy. The new person is expected to make you happy. No, you first have to heal and make yourself happy before you feel that you are ready to enter into a new relationship. Most people enter into new relationships more broken, same things they used to do in their old ones, and it doesn't lead to somewhere. It even puts unnecessary pressure on the new person you are in with, because you're expecting so much from the person. You expect the person to make you happy, and when the person doesn't, then you feel disappointed and discouraged. No, work on yourself first. Don't expect anyone to make you happy. No, it doesn't work that way. You need to make yourself happy. I remember when I'd woken up fresh. Oh my God, I was in so much pain. I was so hurt. And I remember I woke up in the middle of the night and I cried so hard. I cried so bitterly. And I heard, that's the first time I heard God speak to me audibly. I had heard him say, Jenny, if you knew what I just did, you wouldn't be crying on your bed by now. You'll be thanking me. I was so shocked. I was so scared because that was the first time I'd heard God's voice. And all of a sudden, I didn't even know how my tears got dried up. Honestly, I didn't know. But I went down on my knees and I thanked him. It didn't make sense at that time though, but when I think about it now, it makes so much sense. And I wouldn't have been blessed and married today if that didn't happen. So, and I wouldn't also be here encouraging and motivating you. So I want you to know that whoever is trying to move on now, this is just a season, this is just a phase. It shall pass, and God is going to blow your mind. Some people feel like good men don't exist, godly men and women don't exist. Trust me, there are so many out there. You are just doubting. You are even doubting God. You are doubting the fact that you are fit enough for God to bless you with such a person. Sweetheart, there are people enjoying their relationships. There are people enjoying their marriages, and God is also going to bless you with that. But how do you expect him to bring someone new to you when you're still holding on to the past? When you're still holding on and they are refusing to move on? And I want you to know something. If God takes something away from you, he's going to replace it with something much better. God hears our prayers. God really, really hears our prayers. So be mindful of what you tell God, because I quite remember when I was in a relationship, I used to pray to God that, God, let your will be done. If this relationship is not according to your will, let us break up and see what happened. And sometimes when we pray this prayer and later it happens, we start blaming God. God, why did you let this breakup happen? Why did you let this person hurt me? Forgetting that you prayed this prayer. So if God can hear this prayer, then God can also hear the fact that you need someone who would love and respect and cherish you. Someone who would respect you and respect him. You get me? I know you get me. I know you get me. So please, you are worth pursuing. You are worth being treated right. So work on yourself. When God sees that you have recovered and you are ready to be in a relationship, he is going to bless you. He's going to bless you, because that person who is meant to be with you is supposed to help you achieve your God-given purpose on earth. Yes, people want godly men, godly women. Yes, there are people like that, but they are not meant for you. They're not meant for you. Your ex will be happy with someone else. That is who God has purposed him or her to be with. And you're also going to be blessed with someone else. This is just a phase. God is going to bless you and blow your mind. So I hope this little tips would help you. I pray it does help you. And I can't wait to see you glowing and happy once again. And till next time, stay blessed.